I'm here with quilt artist Gail Wild, and Gail, you've brought this really cool collage, stamping, stenciling, I don't even know what to call it, it's a piece of art.
Thank you. This is silk painting on a silk handkerchief, a white silk handkerchief, and it's embellished with silk satin and other flowers that are embellished and painted. So let's get started by cutting our flowers out here on the cutting machine.
Okay, so you're just gonna press cut and start, and that's gonna go for ya.
All right, and while that's cutting, let's get started. So this is clear, washable, resist. And what we're going to do is we're going to stamp some areas on this silk so that it remains white. Now it's hard to see like this, but when we start painting, you will be amazed.
And you showed me a trick, of course, which is the way that you know where to stamp all your flowers is this drawing.
I do this Sharpie drawing to put underneath it. And you can see that I have one under here, so I can find out where to put our paint. So this is a water-based polymer paint. We're gonna start with a wash to see where is that resist.
So basically, a resist is just what it says, right? It's something that's going to not let the paint adhere to the silk surface.
Yes.
It's kind of like watercolor artists use Friskit. Sometimes you even use masking tape to do it. I've heard embossing powder. There's lots of different ways of doing a resist.
Exactly.
And you know what? I'm gonna run over and get those flowers while you're painting.
Oh, fabulous. Thank you, Julie. So we've got our paint on there, and then we are going to add some spray as well to give us some color on here.
And you don't worry at all about mixing mediums like spray and, you know, paint. You just sort of do whatever.
Yes, this is a great combination of colors and paints. And we're gonna let that blend on there. And while we're blending that, what we want to
it
do.
It looks like a sunset. It is so
beautiful. And see how we let the paint do its own work. Now, there are a couple of ways to achieve textures in this, and one of them is to use alcohol. So this is
like
hand
the kind
sanitizer.
You drink, I was gonna say, no.
Yeah,
hand
that
sanitizer.
Would be lovely. Because hand sanitizer, as we know, is kind of thick, and so it's gonna stick better. Now these are scribbles from a hot glue gun. And so what I've done is
so when you make these kind of stencils with a hot glue gun, my understanding is you work on a Teflon sheet or something like that so you can peel it back up.
That is correct, Julie, because we want it to stay there and be flat on one side. So you can see these are lumpy on one side and flat on the other. So I'm putting them flat side down onto our paint, and then I'm going to press them on with this blue block. Now, if you're not a glue gun guy, you can use a block that's got this same thing. Put a little of that alcohol
on
there.
You could use a stamp. I mean, you can use a lot of different tools. It's whatever you want.
Yes, and with that alcohol, it's going to move that paint around. So we're gonna let that paint move around a little bit and finish our landscape here.
So are you not using any water with this because you've already watered your paints, or is this the consistency of them?
Well, both, Julie. See, I like the intensity of the color. I think the bold color is part of what makes this fabulous. So I like that, and I also like the textures that you get with these different colors mixing together.
Mm-hmm.
And
I do too. The blending is absolutely gorgeous, and it does make it feel more natural somehow. It reminds me so much of watercolor.
Yes, it is very much watercolor-like, exactly. So now let's see how we did with our resists here. You can see how the alcohol has worked a bit there and left us with some outlines.
And I know you have one here that's a little more dry. And I'll also point out you're working on top of freezer paper.
That's correct, Julie. Silk likes to be stabilized. Then it doesn't go through the silk and onto the paper behind. So there's a lot of ways to do that. But
so I was gonna say, for people who don't know, freezer paper, when you heat it with an iron, it will melt the sort of waxy side of it, right? And it will adhere onto that silk handkerchief. It's brilliant, and it comes off and you can reuse it over and over. I love that.
Yes, and the paint doesn't stick to it, so it's easy to clean up.
So you're using a different kind of paint now.
Yes, this is a paint marker, and this is a metallic, because we know metallic rocks.
A little bit of shiny makes me happy.
Right? And then I use these stamps for detail. Now, you might have noticed that these are the same stamps that I used before
for the resist.
Yes, yes.
Oh, so you're creating rhythm
exactly.
then.
Exactly, and
repetition. Is the resist gonna resist that paint or not?
The resist will resist the paint. So you can actually use it as a resist.
Mm.
You know, so if we were to paint the next layer, because I mean, it is all about the layering, isn't it? And so if we wanted to add more paint now, these lavender bushes would stay, which is wonderful. Because the layering is really about all the different textures and colors coming together.
Well, I also like the idea that I never think about that. You can take these fine liner paint markers and you can just squeeze the paint out and use them with a brush, or you can use actually the fine liner portion of it.
Yes, because you can get all
kinds. Oh, that's so pearlescent. It does look like little beads almost.
Isn't it fabulous? And like you said, this is just fun. I mean, you can just do everything you want here. You can go out here, you can come in the middle and make lines, you can just go
crazy. And I can see you're not being careful, you're not stressing over it, you're very relaxed.
Yeah, because it's fun. And actually, this is the one we used for the beginning here, and you can come in and add, oh, I don't know, maybe you want some stems in here, maybe you just want some more grasses or some leaves going on with that. So that's kind of fun too. These are fabulous.
Just to play with.
Now the last thing that we want to do is we want to
say I have these flowers that I cut for you.
Now at home I would sew these on, but here I think we'll just glue them.
So how do we get from these white flowers?
Yes. Oh, so we have our paint here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we just take these and
paint
voila.
And you're not even covering them all the way. You're letting it be a little mottled.
Let that do its thing. Yes, exactly. Because that's how flowers are. That's the wonderful thing
about
this.
And how does it get so dimensional and curved like the one in your hand?
So I curl them up, you know, like where they're wet now, I curl them up, I'll pin them, I'll whatever, you know, stake them to the board. And then they dry with starch on them and stay put.
Mm.
So I'm just going to use a little bit of glue on this one rather than sewing. Let's just put
now I noticed that these ones are more see-through and these ones are more opaque. So you can use different kinds of fabrics.
You can use anything. And honestly, paper, fabric, these are silk organza, the satin, anything you want for these dimensional flowers and add them to there.
Such a cool idea. It looks fantastic. Thank you, Gail. This has been wonderful.
Thank you, Julie.